Hello everyone, a good day to all of you. Hope you're having a good time. So we at the M.I.C.E Labs, the Medical Innovation, Creativity and Entrepreneurship Lab set up at JJ Hospital, have come out with different technologies and trying to implement into the hospital setup. We are trying to even motivate students, inspiring them to take up to different kinds of innovations that is possible in using technology and clubbing engineers and doctors together. So till now we had been conducting sessions on various microcontrollers. Just very recently we have started off to even figure out how Arduino can be helpful. So using Arduino, so there are many versions in Arduino. So first thing we are trying to do over here is, you can see an Arduino Uno which is connected to the computer via a USB cable, and using this connection we are basically trying to utilize Arduino for programming. So basically Arduino is nothing but a microcontroller. A microcontroller basically again means that it's a chip, or it's a chipset which consists the brain, or the, you know, the system where you can program and control this electronic circuit. So Arduino has acts as a brain of the system, which controls the various parts. So like in a human body, the brain gives the commands to sensors, and similarly we have Arduino, which acts as the brain to any electronic system. So Arduino is typically not a microcontroller, but it has a microcontroller. So you see this black color chip. So it is a microcontroller which is basically there, which would help you integrate it with different more functions. So these are different ports over here. You can see analog ports, you can see the power ports. So you can basically have 3.3 and 5 volts as a power output from the Arduino when you connect it, get an external battery, or you give a connection to it. So based on that you'll get different power outputs. If you connect a multimeter over here, you can actually see 5 volts coming, you can actually see 3.3 volts coming. So there is analog ports and there are digital ports in the Arduino. So this is a very simple experiment which I have done over here. It's basically blinking an LED. So you can see an LED over there. So I'm basically used a LED from a kit known as B-Kit. B-Kit means basic electronic assembly kit, which is made by the company known as B-Box. So B-Box is into making such innovative stuff which can be used for education and for people to make innovative projects. So this is the resistor. It's a 200 ohm resistor, and I've used that, connecting that into the pin. So the negative of the LED goes to the ground port, and the positive of the you can see it's on the ground port, and the positive of the, and the resistor doesn't have any positive or negative. So the resistor is connected to the 13 number pin. So for Arduino Uno and versions of Arduino, you need to connect it to the pin number 13 simply by connecting a resistor along with, in series with a resist with a LED. You can make it you can connect it to the circuit board, but that doesn't actually finish off. For any object you need to have, for any electronic object, you need to have a hardware and you need to have a software. So you can see over here we have a hardware over here done. So once this hardware is ready, what we have done is we have gone for a software. So in the software, Arduino itself provides, the company Arduino provides a software that is known as Arduino IDE. So using Arduino IDE, this software actually helps you in different various functions. So Arduino IDE is a place where you can make your own program using C language. So using C language, you can actually program this. So for blink LED, you need to go to file, then go to examples, and you can go say basics, and you say blink. So once you press blink, you will see a file that comes up So this file is known as the, it is basically the program, so you can understand the language over here. So the whole blink, so over here there's a given description. Blink turns on LED for 1 second and then off for 1 second repeatedly. So that happens in a continuous loop, it happens in a continuous cycle. So over here you will see the syntax for the whole program, and then once you are done with the syntax, you can press upload over here. So once you press upload, then you will see a green color option coming over here, and it will say uploading. And once uploading is done, then you can actually see the Arduino, on the Arduino, that the hardware actually responds to the software which is there inside. So we will come up with some more exciting stuff using Arduino. Blinking an LED is very basic, so we'll use Arduino for more other functions. And we all know where you can use this blinking of a LED in different medical applications. It is very much available in an hospital. Medical applications, it is possible for to use a blinking of an LED. But for blinking of an LED, you need not have such a big Arduino circuit. You can even do it by small controls. But we're trying to give you an example how to use this Arduino. Okay, so stay tuned. We'll be giving you more updates onto this. Thank you. Have a nice day.